Hey Chance, how's it going? Swiss Maverick is here with some Far Cry 3 gameplay. In this video I'm gonna just show you guys what Far Cry 3 is all about. Some stuff you can do. So maybe I get you interested in also buying the game, because I gotta say I played for quite a few hours now. And it is a lot of fun. It is pretty much what you expect from an open world game. Such as the previous Far Cry's, such as Assassin's Creed, or you might even compare it to GTA in some ways. So you got this like absolutely incredibly huge world, very beautiful. It's an island, probably somewhere in the Pacific. I don't think it's like somewhat realistic, or I mean a real island. It's just a fictive one. But it's very beautiful terrain, as you can see here, if you look around a bit. And yet there's extremely much stuff to do. So what I do right here is I'm gonna climb a radio tower. Also here you can compare it to like Assassin's Creed or something. You have to get around on the island. You can. The maps are not revealed from the beginning, you know. So you have to find those radio towers, you can climb up on them and then disable this this electronic device, whatever the hell it is, and that's gonna unlock an area on the map. So after that you see the roads and all that stuff, and although also some like markers, you know, where treasures are hidden and all that stuff. So that's one important thing, you have to clear those radio towers. But that's like just one of so many side missions, if you want to call it that. You got those radio towers, you got like pirate camps that you can or have to clear out in order to get respawn points. So this is the map here. The whole map is like two islands, it's like the north and the southern island. And I'm still on the northern part right now, and it's huge, it's incredible. I've never seen such a huge map in the game, I think. So what I do here is I just spotted some pirates down there, so I'm gonna take them out, and then I'm gonna use the rope here to like get down faster. Whoop, that wasn't good. Freaking dogs or something, or dingoes. Yeah, another aspect of this game is the wildlife. If you have played Assassin's Creed 3, you just saw some wildlife, you know. But right here it's absolutely incredible how many different animals there are. And they're really dangerous sometimes. So there's like tigers and dingoes and bears, and you got all kinds of animals and predators, and it's sometimes very dangerous, especially if you're not like focusing on your. Oh man, that sucked. Okay. If you're not focusing on what's going on around you, so it's very important to always keep your eyes open, to always listen for like animal sounds, you know, because it can happen that you're somehow hiding in a bush, you know, stalking some pirates, and all of a sudden you get a freaking tiger up your ass. So it's very dangerous. And it's jungle, obviously. Alright, so took out those pirates. What I was trying to say before is what you can do. I mean, there's like the towers, the radio towers you have to clear to reveal the map. You have to clear the enemy camps to like, clear the area of pirates. And to support like the rebels that are also on this island. So you're your friends, if you want to call it that. You see the red areas on the map, those areas are still like guarded by the pirates, and the areas that are no longer red are guarded by the rebels, so this gives you an idea about if it's safe or not, you know. All those blue markers are side missions. You get some side missions where you interact with like civilians, where you can help them with something. You get side missions where you have to hunt a specific animal, or just like hunt a few animals with a specific weapon. You get special like kill side missions where you have to clear a smaller area with about 5 or 6 pirates, and you have to kill the leader just with a knife. And this is one of like hundreds of side missions. It's absolutely incredible how much stuff there is in this game. So this is about what you can do. And then obviously there's like the main story, you know, where you go from point to point and complete tasks for the rebels, complete tasks for specific people. Also there, the variety is crazy. Ouch, that hurt. The variety is crazy. I mean, you can, the main missions, sometimes it's like a fighting mission where you're supporting the rebels against the pirates in a fight where you have to do something. Sometimes it's almost like Indiana Jones style, where you have to to go through a temple, you know. It's more like jump and run climbing adventure mission, and sometimes it's more like a memory flash, you know. It's kind of weird. Some, you even do drugs at times in this game, and then it's almost like an LSD trip, you know. Some kind of weird dream missions, but there are only a few. I don't really like them too much, but yeah, they're not too many. So as I said, a lot of stuff to do, absolutely incredible. I've played by now, I don't know, maybe 12-15 hours or something, and I'm maybe on 30% of the story. I can't even tell you, but it takes a lot of time to clear all those towers, clear all the camps and stuff, so you're not gonna be bored anytime soon if you buy the game. So what we got here is a camp. As I said, important to clear those camps to get fast travel locations. What I did here with the camera, you can like zoom in, you can observe, and then it's gonna mark the targets for you, and then you have to clear them out. I'm usually using silenced weapons. It gives you an advantage, but if you're too close, they're still gonna like hear the shot, you know, and they're gonna come for you eventually. One thing that is important are the alarm poles that are in those camps. If the guards spot you, they're gonna trigger the alarm, and then more pirates are gonna come with a vehicle. What I did there, I saw a cage inside that hangar, or inside that building. And sometimes the pirates are like, or have captured animals, you know, like bears and tigers, and they have them in those cages. And by shooting at the cages, you can actually release the animal. So as you can hear now, there's a lot of shit going on in that camp. That's because I released a bear that was trapped, or that was, yeah, holding that in that cage. And the bear is pretty much gonna do the work for me. So he's gonna engage those pirates, he's gonna distract them. I can just see what he's doing and just wait. Maybe he gets to kill all of them, maybe not. Or I can like interact and take out a few, almost in order to protect the bear, you know. So yeah, a few of the pirates came out, a few got killed by the bear, and now it's cleared. And depending on how you clear those camps, you're gonna get positive experience points, or get more experience points. You see here, I got 1500 XP because I like silently cleared out this camp. If you just go in loud and then you get spotted and the alarm gets triggered, you get lesser experience points. All right, so camp capture. You see in this cage here, the was the bear actually, or even two, maybe. And now I got like a building here where I can go in. And this is like the, yeah, you're another side mission collecting SD cards, you know. It's just one of many things you can collect in the game. And then you get those like vending machines. There's weapon vending machines. Kind of crazy idea, but I like it. And from here you can buy weapons. You can customize your weapons. You can bring on different different items, you know, such as silencers, extended mag, red dot, reflex and stuff. So yeah, depending on the weapon you use, you get more or less slots that you can fill. And yeah, you get different items, you know. So I got an MP5 here, reflex, and then a silencer. You see here the submachine guns, quite a few. You can buy a lot of ammunition, explosives, all that stuff. You get a few pistols that you can buy. Here, important to know, by like clearing those radio towers, this will unlock weapons for you for free. So the more radio towers you clear, the more weapons you can get here from those stores without even paying for them. So quite a selection of weapons, everything a soldier hearts and desires, I guess. And yeah, just tuned myself up a bit, got some more ammo, do some med kitting here. And as you can see, now I got rebels here. As soon as you clear an area, the rebels will come in and take it over. Here on the map you see a diamond. Those are the, like the treasure chests, and in those chests you get you get some money, usually cash, and sometimes you can pick up items.
Taking care of jobs on the bulletin board would help us greatly.
Our work isn't done. And sell them afterwards in the store. On every camp you get this, like the billboard or the bulletin board, and from here you can do some more side missions, hunting missions, and special kill missions. This is very important, the crafting menu. You can pick up a lot of herbs on the map. With those herbs you can create different syringes, you know, for health and other specific stuff. Then important here is like the backpack upgrade, you know. You, by killing animals and skinning them, you can get a lot of items and like the fur and stuff. And you can craft upgraded equipment afterwards, you know. So, for example, I got quite a few things already, but it's important to do that so you can carry more weapons, more explosives, you can carry even more, you get more weapon slots, you know, you start with one weapon slot, and then if you upgrade this, you get a second weapon slot, up to four weapons, so I can carry four weapons at a time at this point, and a lot of ammunition, so that's cool, but it's maybe not too realistic to carry around an RPG and two assault rifles and a sniper rifle, you know. Okay, let's continue. What you see here is the like the skill menu. With the experience points you gain by completing tasks and stuff, you get upgrades, or you can unlock upgrades, and they're like separated in three different categories. One is more like on the health side of things, one is more on the attack and some special skills, you know. So also there it's important to gain experience points to unlock more skills and to make you more effective in combat. On an island as big as the one in Far Cry 3, it's important to get around rather quickly. There's a lot of ways to do that. The easiest way is using fast travel. So you get fast travel stations in all the major cities and in all the camps that you have cleared out. That is one way to do it. Another way is driving. as you see here. It's not too great. I mean, it's not nothing to compare to, like, whoa, that was close. If you compare it to GTA or something, the driving physics are really cool. In this game, they're not. But it's enough to get from A to B, you know. And you get different vehicles. Maybe sometimes it's just like a regular vehicle. Sometimes it's like a Jeep. You even get Jeeps with guns on top. And you can use the glider, as you've seen it before. You can use boats, jet skis, quads, and yeah, all that stuff, you know. So you find a lot of vehicles spread around on the map, and it's pretty neat to get fast from A to B if you don't want to use the fast travel locations all the time. So I just picked up a statue there, or another thing that you can collect, like, I don't know, hundreds of statues and other things spread around the map, and you can or you have to collect them. Another part of the side missions, you know. So right now I'm using a jet ski after the vehicle. Also there, it's cool to use, it's fun, but it's not like the physics are not super great or anything. You get also different boats like Zodiacs or patrol boats with weapons on it. A lot of stuff to do, and also fun to use it to destroy something. In this next part here, I'm gonna show you guys a hunter side mission. Hunting is very important in this game, especially at the beginning, where you're practically not able to carry a lot of weapons or ammunition. I advise you to do the hunting mission or the hunter missions, because with that, with the collected fur and all that, connected skins, you can afterwards craft yourself more bags and shit, you know, so you can carry more weapons and more more ammunition for your weapons. So this is very important if you wanna carry decent equipment, you know. So this is actually a hunter side mission, but you can also just walk around and hunt yourself, you know, without having to start a mission. There are a lot of animals, they're all over the place, so it's not gonna be hard to find some. What I'm using here is the bow, you know, very nice weapon, and I have to hunt this specific or this special red, I don't even know what it's called, badass lizard. But there's quite a few here, I gotta be careful. Side note, pretty much all the animals in this game are dangerous. So you can be attacked by pretty much anything you see. Even though if you think, yeah, that's not a dangerous animal, be aware, if you go too close, they're gonna attack you, or they're gonna ram you, you know, if you go too close to a bull or something. So careful. So I have to skin this one here. But I'm kinda scared that the other one is gonna get me. I'm just making a run for it. He's gone for me. One of my favorite weapons here, the bow and arrow. It seems to be like every game this year brings out or uses this weapon. I mean, AC3 obviously, because you're playing in an Indian. Far Cry 3, Crysis 3 is gonna be something similar. And this one is a lot of fun because you can, after a while, after a few unlocks, you can, as you can see here, I'm just crafting a special grenade belt with the skin I just collected. Yeah, for this, for the arrow or the bow and arrow in this game here, you can craft special arrows. Some are just like the regular arrows, as you just have seen me using them. But you can afterwards create or craft explosive and like fire arrows. So this is a lot of fun to use, I'm gonna tell you that. What you see right now is one of the cities that are spread around on the map. Those are like non-weapon zones, you know. If you're in there, your weapon is like hidden, you don't see it in front of you, and you cannot engage anyone, so this is like the peace area. And what you get is usually a fast travel spawn, you know. You get a weapon store, and sometimes you get some games, such as the right there, I could play some darts and stuff. So it's like cool area to hang out. What you see here is like a graphic glitch or a bug. I'm kind of hidden or trapped behind a waterfall. So stuff like that happens sometimes, but it's easy to get out of it by using a fast travel location. Alright, so I hope I've been able to answer the question, what is Far Cry 3? We have not seen too much mission footage. I'm gonna upload a few more videos, so I hope you check in again. And please leave a comment about what you think, if you like the game, if you wanna buy it, or in case you already got the game, what is your opinion about it. Thanks for watching. Maverick out. If you catch me at the border, I got visas in my name. If you come around, hey, I-